Hey, it's Mikey. Let's talk about Black Ops 3 and the Chain Killer. Earn a kill chain medal, that is 9 or more rapid kills. And this is part of the Dark Ops operations. So let's just get into it. First up, your settings. Really important, at least for me. You gotta have a very decent look sensitivity of horizontal and vertical. Nothing too crazy, but you need to have it fast enough to where you can react when you hear people, when you see people fast enough, especially because we're gonna be pretty much in enemy spawn. Okay, me personally, I go with 6 out of 6. That doesn't mean you have to, just something that you're comfortable with that's gonna allow you to quickly, you know, scan the area and react to get those kills. Volume, advanced volume. I like to have the music volume to 0. Sometimes it kicks in and it can mask enemy movement. You know, boost, you can hear the boosting, climbing, people reloading. So music, I have that for 0. And my auto presets, if you decide to go with awareness and dead silence, Super Crunch to me has usually been the best, allows you to hear movements and stuff a little bit easier. All right, game mode. You want a mode that has predictable spawns, so Safeguard could work, Domination, Core or Hardcore. Me, I prefer Hardcore Domination since most weapons are one-shot kills and the enemy minimap isn't always up for them. So that's a nice bonus right there. All right, for the class, I actually use a variation of this class. Okay, you can mix and match whatever you like. This is just a suggestion. Use whatever you're good with. So for me, I like to play hardcore. So the Razorback, like that one, very consistent. Whatever weapon you use, fast mags. Fast mags is gonna minimize your downtime. That's always a good choice. And extended mags, obviously, so that way you don't have to reload as much. It allows you to get those clutch kills. Ghost, always important if you want to flank all the way around, get into enemy spawn. Ghost is just always a good choice. Hardwired, I love this because you can't trip up the shock charges, but most importantly, your mini map will always stay up. So hardwired, really good for that. Fast hands, always good, allows you to ready up, lets you get the jump on someone. I didn't always use it, but it is a very good choice. And in one of the clips you're gonna see, I definitely did use it and it helped a lot. Okay, awareness, it's not as good as it was. They did nerf it recently, but it's still a good choice. Sometimes I had engineer. It really depended on the streaks I was using, but awareness and dead silence, always a good combo. For the streaks, I guess you could use anything you like, but UAV really is the must have. There really is no replacement for intel on the enemy knowing where they're at. Okay, after the UAV, use whatever you like, care pack, counter UAV, anything really. The thing is though, if you do use care packages, it can be a distraction and, you know, take you away from your goal. If this is your goal to get this chain kill, then probably you want to stick with UAV, counter UAV. All right, specialists, battery and her kinetic armor. You usually want to pop it after you've killed maybe 2 or 3 enemies, or if you see a group of enemies and you really want to make sure you kill them. So for the playstyle, you're going to need to rush their spawn and kill off a few when they respawn. Okay, there's just no way about that. You need to kill 9 people rapidly, and it's a 6v6 situation most of the time. Okay, another thing is you will fail a lot, but with every fail, you will start to learn the spawn patterns, okay? You really need to pay attention. Every time you die, like on a 6 or 7, take a mental note. How did you die? Where did that guy come from? You gotta learn the spawns. Okay, so let's get into the first clip right here. This actually happened on the live stream. I'm using a pistol, and we've already got control of the middle flag and the C flag, and I'm in their spawn, not all the way in there. See this guy, and I check out there. No one's out there. My teammates are, but I know they've been up here for a while. Get these quick kills, and yeah, I end up getting a team kill. Get out of my way, man. And I know where they're gonna spawn. They are gonna be out there, and when you are towards the end of it, that is when it's safe to rush, because you know there's definitely gonna be some people out here. And I got my 6 sensitivity working for me. It allows me to spin around and get them. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is show you a top view, so that way you can see where people are spawning at. I have failed on this map so many times that I know where they're gonna spawn. It's always in that bottom left area and to the right. Okay, so let's watch this top view. As I start killing people, they're always gonna spawn there, and I'm always gonna be greeted by them right there. I already know what's gonna happen as I exit that doorway, and I sort of know where to look. I mean, those are the two places they spawn, and after a bunch of fails on this map, I pretty much knew what to expect. All right, let's move on to clip two. I'm using that Razorback setup that I showed you. So let's get into this. I'm using battery and I heard this guy. So that's where awareness and dead silence worked out. Pop the kinetic armor, wanted to make sure I got that guy. I already knew they're gonna spawn there. And after I kill them there, they're always gonna spawn back here. And this is where me failing over and over again helped me out. There's a good sensitivity. And you notice that I'm kind of spinning around, sort of looking. Okay, that's where the high sensitivity can help you out. It allows you to move around and scan the area faster. And because of all my previous fails, I already knew where to look. Okay, so let's look at the top view. You don't want to bum rush the spawn. You kind of want to have a buffer, because if I were to run into where that big ball is up top, or if I were to run to the bottom right, I would flip the spawns. Okay, I don't want to do that. You want to set a buffer. So let's go ahead and watch this clip. And so here's the top view, and I know where they're going to spawn. It's in that top left or in the back right there, the back middle. I know what to expect. I know where to jump up. I already know where to pre-aim, where to look. And usually when you kill people off of one spawn, you know to look at the next one. And I didn't just get this knowledge magically. It's because I failed all the time. I failed a lot, and that's gonna happen to you no matter what the map is. All right, so hopefully that helps you guys out. Don't get frustrated by all the fails. Learn from them, and you will learn the spawns just like I did, okay? I'm not this great magical MLG player. Just had to fail a bunch of times straight up, and hopefully I can pass this info to you. Do not completely rush into the spawn unless you know that you're on that seventh kill. Then it's okay to just run in there and just go for broke. If you want to come out to the open lobbies, live streams, things like that, Twitter, Facebook, links down below, please take 3 seconds to rate the video. See you next time. All right, so on the left side there, we've got top 5 clips. Each episode features a certain weapon class. The past episodes, we had specialists only, we had melee only. These clips are pretty insane. I don't want to spoil them. Check them out. Playlist there for you, and it's just going to keep getting bigger over time. And on the right side, Black Ops 3 tips, tricks, info, updates, all kinds of stuff. Another playlist, keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen, or I have links down below.